Good morning, children. Welcome back to our science class. In the previous class, we have studied about some uses of leaves. And not only them, we have some more uses of the leaves. And we are using leaves in many ways in our daily life. So, in this class, let us discuss about some more uses of leaves. This is part 2 of lesson 3, leaf. And coming to the uses of leaves, we also eat the leaves of many plants as vegetables. We must have eaten vegetables made from spinach, mustard, methi, cabbage, leaves, etc. And these leaves are used as vegetables for us. See, here we have a picture of leafy vegetables. Here we can observe so many leafy vegetables. These leafy vegetables are mixed in the dal and they may be cooked. And there sometimes they can be made as chutneys also. And they are very helpful for the body. They give vitamins and minerals to our body. So these leaves of many plants are used as vegetables. And here we have so many examples. Fenugreek, spinach, cabbage, curry leaves. So many leaves are there here. All these leaves are used as vegetables for us. So leaves of many plants are used as vegetables. Next, these leaves have become a part of our daily life in very many different ways. We often see pictures and drawings of leaves at many places. See here, we have some pictures in this. So curtains, saris and rangoli. Everywhere we can observe leaf designs. So curtain designs, sari borders, paintings, rangoli, temple carvings often have leaf designs on them. This makes them look beautiful and attractive. See here, rangoli, it is very attractive, very beautiful. Curtain designs, sari borders, all are looking very beautiful. So these leaf designs makes them beautiful and attractive. So leaf designs are used on curtains, saris, rangoli, temple carvings, etc., which makes them look beautiful and attractive. Next one is shedding of leaves. In certain seasons of the year, we see very many leaves lying on the lawns and the roads. Usually, we can observe these in the month of February and March for our weather. So, this shows that the leaves of the plants are not permanent. They remain on the plant only till they are able to perform their function well. When they become old, the plants shed them off. See, in the picture, we can observe clearly the old leaves are shedding off from the plant. So, these old leaves, when they become old, the plant shed them off and new leaves then grow up to take their place. So, in place of these old leaves, new leaves will grow. The old leaves keep on getting shed and new leaves keep on coming in their place. So, in certain seasons, old leaves keep on getting shed and new leaves keep coming in their place. The shedding of the leaves here has also helped in throw out the harmful waste that get collected in its old leaves. There is another use of shedding these leaves. When they become old, they shed off from the plant. Not only that, these shedding of leaves also help the plant to throw out the harmful waste that get collected in its old leaves. So along with these old leaves, the harmful waste also will be shedding off from the trees. Usually, it will be observed in the month of February and March in some seasons. So what happens to the old leaves when they shed off from the plant? What happens to them? So, these old leaves, when they shed off from the plants, these leaves should be collected. What should we do with the old leaves which are shedding off from the plants and trees? We should collect and dump all the fallen leaves and along with our kitchen waste in a pit. So all these fallen leaves should be collected, and also the kitchen waste which we are using in our house, it should be also collected, and all this waste should be kept in a pit. This waste can then be covered with moist soil. So after keeping all the leaves and kitchen waste, we should cover this pit with some moist soil. When it is left for 2 or 3 months, it becomes compost. So it will become compost. Collect all the fallen leaves and kitchen waste in a pit, and this can be covered with moist soil. And later on, it should be left for 2 or 3 months. Then it becomes compost. And this compost can be used in the fields. Compost helps the plants and crops to grow better. It is the natural manure for the plants. When this compost is used in the fields, the plants and crops will grow better. This is the usefulness of the compost. So how should we make this compost? Collect the fallen leaves and kitchen waste in a pit, and this can be covered with moist soil. When it is left for 2 or 3 months, it becomes compost. And the pit where we have collected all these fallen leaves and kitchen waste, and we should cover it with moist soil, this is called a compost pit. What do you call it? It is called compost pit. And later on, after 2 or 3 months, this compost pit should be opened, and this will be turned into compost. That compost is to be taken out from the pit, and it should be used in the fields, crop fields. Why? Because this compost is very useful for the plants and crops to grow better. It is a natural manure. No artificial manures or nothing. It is a natural manure which helps the plants and crops to grow better. This is called compost pit. Now, let us see the assignment for this part 2, lesson 3. Answer the following questions. How is compost useful for plants and crops? This we have studied in the third slide. And draw a picture of leaf and color it. Very easy. So any shape you can draw. That picture of leaf should be drawn and it should be colored. What is the color of the leaf? You just recollect in your mind. Color it. Once again, let us have a check what we have studied today. So, coming to the uses of the leaves in part 2, leaves of many plants are used as vegetables. So, we use them in our diet to give us vitamins and minerals. And these leaf designs are used in our daily life on curtain designs, sari borders, rangoli, temple carvings, etc. This makes them look beautiful and attractive. Next one is shedding of leaves. In certain seasons, old leaves keep on getting shed and new leaves keep coming in their place. We can observe these leaves lying on the lawns and the roads, and the shedding of the leaves also help in throw out the harmful waste that get collected in its old leaves. Along with the old leaves, the harmful waste also will be collected and sent out from the tree. Next one is compost pit. See here, that fallen leaves which are shedding from the trees, they should be collected along with the kitchen waste in a pit, and this can be covered with moist soil. When it is left for 2 or 3 months, it becomes compost. This compost can be used in the fields, and this compost helps the plants and crops to grow better. It is a natural manure. And assignment, answer the following questions. Two questions are there. How is compost useful for plants and crops? And draw a picture of leaf and color it. Any shape of the leaf you can draw, which I have told in the part one, and you can color it. You know the color of the leaf and you can color it. So observe the video carefully and answer the following questions. So this picture, you draw it neatly and color it neatly. Somewhat visible leaf you draw, not very small. So some visible leaf you draw it and color it. Thank you, children.